In this video, I'm going to review Graficto, the ultimate infographic maker. I'm going to take you inside Graficto. We'll talk about the pricing. By the way, stick with me because for a limited time, I'm going to show you how you can get this for a one-time price. And lastly, I'll give you my personal thoughts about Graficto. So if you're ready, let's dive right in. So what is Graficto? Graficto is a cloud-based infographic maker that will help you to create powerful, smart infographics and visuals without any design skills. Now, who is this tool best suited for? Well, anyone who wants to communicate information to their audience using an image. This can span any niche and any industry. But if you're an affiliate marketer like me, then some of the situations where Graficto would come in handy is creating an infographic for your blog. As you know, infographics are a great way to summarize your blog post idea in an image. It also helps your readers to get through your content quickly and retain that information. But most importantly, it's great for SEO because it can be shared. It's a fantastic way to build backlinks. You can also use infographics on your landing pages, YouTube videos, social media posts, and your webinars. You can also create infographics as a side hustle. The applications are left to your imagination. Graficto is ideal for those of us who are graphically challenged because, as you'll see, it's very easy to use. So let's go inside and I'll show you around. All right, guys, we're now inside the members area of Graficto. And as you can tell, it's a very simple layout here, not much to this. And you're going to see that this extends to creating the infographic as well. Very, very simple. So this drop down here, you can access your account settings. You can log out. And down over here is where you can create your graphic. So if you click on this button, you'll be able to start the creation process. But I want to go over some of these other menu options here. So obviously, this takes you back to the home screen. This is where you can access any graphics that you created. And this is also where you can access any of the templates within Graficto. Now you can see they're all separated by category over here, so you can choose which one you want. But we're going to go here and just click on this button right here, create a graphic. Now when we click on that button, Graficto brings up all the templates that are available to you. So there are a lot of different templates, a lot of different use cases. But if you want to separate them by category, all you have to do is click on any of these buttons up here. So you can choose from lists, process, cycle, chart, timeline, relationship, steps, funnels, and they have a miscellaneous category. So let's go ahead and I'm going to put together an infographic for you because I want to show you how simple this really is. So we're going to go through a timeline here. Actually, no, we're going to go with steps. Let's go with steps here. And we're going to create a step and we're going to go with this one right here. Let's preview this right here. You can tell whenever you click on any of these or hover over, you can preview or use a template. So in this case, I'm going to hover over this. I want to preview this. And what this does is it tells you how many items that are supported by this particular template. In this case, I can go up to 10 steps. There's gradient colors as well as icons. So you can see it right here. This is a sample of what it would look like. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to use this template. So we're going to launch that template and right up here, you can give it a name. So I'm going to call this 7-step action plan. And from here, this is item number one right here. Item number one is this item right here. Now you can choose the icons based off of your needs. So in this case, I'm going to choose numbers. So I'll look for a number. I'm going to number these in order of 1 through 7. So the first one I'm going to choose is number one right here. And you can see it instantly changes it here. So you get a nice little preview of what your infographic is going to look like. And in terms of the title, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up this document that has all of the information that I'm planning on using here. So I'm going to use this one right here. I'm just going to copy and drop this in here. And you can see as soon as I paste it in, it adds it right here. Now under the description, I'm going to put a description in here. Copy that. I'm going to paste it in. And you can see this is what it looks like so far. Now, One thing that you are going to want to understand about Graficto is that there are some character limits when it comes to the titles and the descriptions. So you can't put an entire novel into Graficto and expect it to print out over here. The main goal is to utilize infographics as a way to establish understanding, to help your viewer understand the concept of what your image or your article or story is all about. So you want to be as brief as possible to summarize the meaning of your content. So that is step number one, and this is called niche simplicity. Now I'm going to add another item. And as soon as I clicked on that, here's another one that popped up over here. We are going to change this icon and we're going to look for the number two. I'm going to put that in there. And I'm going to choose the title for number two, which is Rock Solid Foundation. I'm going to copy that. We're going to paste it in there. And you're going to see, again, very, very easy, right? There's nothing to it. This is very, very helpful for those of us who are graphically challenged, myself included. Now we're going to add in the description here for number two, or step number two. I'm just going to copy this and I'm going to paste it in there. And you can see everything just lines up real nice and looks really good so far. So I'm going to add in another item. I'm going to do item number three, or step number three. I'm going to add this in here. I'm going to copy that, paste it in. I'm going to add in the description. So it's very helpful for you to have all this information pre-written. And if your description or your title goes a little long, then you'll just have to figure out a way to shorten it, because you don't want to have too much text. Again, this is an infographic. It's there to really convey the idea of your blog post or your video or presentation so that people aren't stuck there reading through the entire thing, all right? So it's more of a summary. So I'm going to add that in there. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through, I'm going to add the rest of the seven steps. I'm going to speed up this video so you guys don't have to sit here and watch me go through all seven steps. All right, so I completed all seven steps. As you can see, this looks really nice. Everything is color-coded. Everything looks nice and tidy. Now, once you've added all the items that you want to add, then you can go ahead, you can check out some of the other options here. This one, this says heading here, and it says this template does not have any headings, so we're gonna skip over that. In terms of colors, you're gonna notice here, they've got a wide array of colors. Now, one thing that I noticed here was that there was no ability for me to customize the colors to the way that I want them to be. So if I have some brand colors, I am unable to do that, but they do give you a wide range of colors. So this is very, very helpful in terms of creating the infographic and not worrying about picking colors. I just pick something that I think looks nice and I can go with that. So I like the first one the best. I just like this variety of colors. So I'm just gonna leave it like that. They even have fonts here. There are 17 fonts that you can choose from right here. So you pick the one that you like. I'm going to leave it at Open Sans. I think that looks nice. And down over here, if you click on this, these are different templates. Again, if you want to use a different template, then you can do so by clicking on any of them right here. Now, once you are done, you're going to notice here that Graficto will save your infographic as you are working on it. So it makes it very convenient. If something happens, you can always come back and Graficto would have saved your infographic. The next step here is you can download your graphic if you want to, but I want to show you guys this share button right here. So when you want to share this and make this public, you just toggle this on here and you can make it public on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Pinterest, or you can copy the link and post it on your social media platform, whichever one that you want. And when you're ready to go, all you have to do is click on the download button right here. And you're gonna see that there are four formats that you can download this in. JPEG, PNG opaque, which means that if I were to download this in PNG opaque, the white background would show up. PNG transparent means that the background would be transparent. So that way you can bring that into another application and do a special background for it. And there is also SVG format, which is scalable vector graphics. So if you've got other graphical applications that you want to pull in and you want to reconfigure, you want to do additional, more advanced types of editing, then you can use the SVG format. What we're going to do is we're going to just download this as a PNG transparent. There's even a button here to download this as 4K high resolution, but I'm just going to download this as PNG transparent. So what we're going to do now is we are going to download this to our computer here, and then we're going to pull this up and I'm going to show you what it looks like. So there you go. This is what the download looks like right here. Now, if I were to pull this into another desktop design software, I could add a nice colorful background in here and just make it really, really nice. But this is how simple it is to use Graficto. There's not much to this app, which is the reason why I'm saying that for those of us who are graphically challenged, this is an app that is going to really, really help you. So now let's go ahead and I'll give you my pros and cons and I'll give you my final opinion. All right, let's talk about the pros and cons of Graficto. First, let's start with the cons. There are character limits for the title and descriptions, but this is a good thing because you want to be brief and not long-winded. The whole point of an infographic is to convey your ideas in a succinct, graphical manner, not through a lot of words. They do have a wide selection of colors to choose from, but no way to customize the colors the way that you want. Not yet, at least. And I would like to see more templates. But according to their co-founder, they are adding more on a regular basis. And now for the pros. It's extremely easy to use. As you saw, practically anyone can create an infographic. It's cloud-based, so nothing to install on your computer. Just log in and you're good to go. Its co-founder is very open to suggestions from the user community on how to improve the app. This is huge because they are allowing the users to have their say in developing this app. And most importantly, there is a limited time, one-time price offer. There are no upsells or additional purchases. Link in the description. So, should you get Graficto? Well, in my opinion, it is well worth the one-time price, especially if you will be using infographics in your business. Again, you can use this in your blog posts, landing pages, YouTube videos, social media posts, and webinars. There are a lot of applications for Graficto. Just imagine the overall cost and time savings you'll experience when using this online tool. If you want to grab your copy of Graficto for a limited time, one-time price, just click on the link below. Deals like this don't last forever, so your best bet is to get it now. Thanks so much for watching. This is Ken Furukawa from KenFurukawa.com, and I'll see you in my next video.